Welcome everyone to Neverwinter on PC. My name is Rainer and today we are going to dive into the Summer Festival. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like. And if you would like to see more informational videos about Neverwinter, hit the subscribe button. The Summer Festival is probably one of the most complicated events in Neverwinter. There are many aspects in here, campaign currencies, event currencies, I should say, rewards and mini games. There's a lot going on. I will try to give you guys a quick overview on as much as I can. I hope it's quick, but there's a lot to cover. The topics for today are going to be, first I'm going to talk about currencies, vendors and rewards. Then I'm going to dive into the dailies. Next up is the Sahha Balls, then the Sahha Match, which is a little bit different again. Then we have mini games on the map that I will cover. And finally, I will look also a little bit into the profession that you have in here. So first, the currencies, vendors and rewards. There are 5 different event currencies, which already is quite crazy. You could even say 7 if you count all the tickets separately, but let's go through them one by one. The first currency in here, there is the petals, and you can use them here in the petal store. You get them basically with everything that you do in here. You will get many, don't worry about that, and you can buy many things with these petals. For example, foods, you can buy this piñata, you can buy these everlasting items that you can use on this map in one of the mini games, but I will get to that later. There are some transmutes in here, some fashion that you can buy, you can also craft this. There's some more fashion here, and you can even get a mount or a companion. I think this companion is new. But yeah, so that's the petals. As I said, the petals you can get basically anywhere. Next up, and I have to walk a little bit for this, you can also get fire blossom flowers, and you can give them to this lady here, where you can buy some of these basic foods, and these foods can be used in professions to make buff foods. Also, you can get this one. This basically gives you also some resources and also, I think, 15 petals. These fire blossom petals, or fire blossom flowers, I should say, you can get by walking in this area behind here. It's this whole area where you can get them, and they will basically be on the ground. Let me show you one. It's these yellow flowers here. If you select them, you can take them. There's always one or two, I don't think three, but one or two in there, and you can collect them. It's pretty easy to collect if you want, and you can use them at this lady here. Next up is the favors of Sune. The favors of Sune basically come from a daily quest. I actually already have the quest. You get it automatically when you enter the map, and after that you can get one per day from Yina, and you can use this favor at this tribute store, where you can get either more petals, of course, or one of these mounts. You can actually get an epic mount in here, which is pretty nice. If you already have this mount, they are all... it's buying on pickup now. Okay, they are buying on pickup, so if you already have it, don't buy it again, just buy some petals, I guess, or keep the favors. I think I still have some favors from last year. No, I don't, at least not on this character. So those are the favors. Next up are the Sahha Balls. I don't have them at the moment, You can get them from another daily, and I will get back to that later. You have to use the Sahha Balls in a party. I will also cover that later, because that is basically the most important thing in this event. When you use the Sahha Balls, you will get the last currency in here, and that's tickets. At first you will get bronze tickets. After 150 kicks you will get silver tickets, and after 300 kicks you will get mithril tickets. Once again, I will cover the balls in a later part of this video. With the tickets, and those are the most important currency in here, you can go to this ticket exchange and you can get a lot of really nice rewards. The couple rewards are some more of these favors of Sune. You can once again get petals. You can unlock some skills for the Sahha Match that I will also cover later. You can get some body paint, fashion, some skins for your Sahha Balls. I think these are skins, or are these actual Sahha Balls? Not really sure. And you can get a chair, which is basically another... it's an emote. Okay, you can unlock an emote here. So those are the copper rewards. You will get a lot of copper tickets, usually. So after 150 kicks, and I will explain it later, you can get silver tickets also. With the silver tickets, you can already get preservation wards. I think these are unbound. And you also can get some nice enchantments, including brutals and black ice enchantments even. I probably will buy some of these, and also brutals for my alternative mains, I will call them. You can also get some RP, pretty nice. So these are already nice rewards. You can also get some insignias. They are rare, which makes them not that great, and they cost 40 silver tickets already for a rare insignia. Better than the insignias, if you want to have guild marks, you can get some strong boxes here, and also a golden bell to summon the Greed of Dragonflight. I don't know if many alliances still run this guild event. I don't think it's really necessary, but influence strong boxes are going to be very popular in here as well, if you already covered this part. Finally, there's also mithril tickets. Those are the super high end rewards, and as you can see, you can get either an epic artifact, an epic mount, or even a legendary mount. These are not guaranteed, these are just chances. They are all bind on pickup as well. Well, at least it's for the raffle item. I don't know if the artifacts, mounts, and mounts are bind on pickup. Anyway, if you don't get one of the top prizes, you will get some Tarmloon trade bars and some silver. Include one of. Okay, so you will either get Tarmloon trade bars or 5 silver tickets. I thought it was both at first. So these all cost 1 mithril ticket, and I will of course try to cover the chances on these in a later video. I don't have any mithril tickets right now, so I cannot do that right now. Anyway, so these are the currencies, vendors, and rewards. So there are some pretty nice things in here. I think there's also a forge hammer in here. Here. Yeah, exactly. You can get a forge hammer of Gond in here. And some nice legendary mounts. So, next up, the dailies. Let's go back to the main lady. So, as I said, when you enter the map, you will get a quest already. You can also pick it up on the Protector's Enclave event podium, I would say. And you can give it to this lady, and you will get automatically a favor of Sune, some petals, because you get petals everywhere, and some of the resources in here. These are random. you will always get a favor of Sumit. You can do this quest every day. All you have to do is go to this Gina Muradi and just talk to her, and you can deliver the quest. It's no work at all. So let's complete this. So we get this stuff. There's also a summer celebration quest here, and this summer celebration gives you also some petals and some other stuff. Some of this stuff is good for professions, which I will cover later again. And yeah, it's not a bad thing to do if you still want to level up your profession, I guess, and you want to do something with professions. Other than that, you have to... Oh, you have to do one of the mini games that I will cover later. I'm not going to... I'm not going to do this one right now. So, those are the two dailies here. There is a third one that's actually more important. Well, if you need a mount, the favor of Sune... token is also important, but the last quest comes from this guy back here. He's all the way up here near this field, and this guy gives you a very own Sahha Ball quest. So this is how you get your Sahha Balls, and this quest actually has two ways of completing. One, you can play a Sahha Match, which you can play in this K menu event Sahha Match. Or you can pick up some flax flowers, and the flax flowers are scattered all around the map. Let me see if I can find them. The bad thing about these flax flowers is that they are a shared resource on the map, so other people can pick them in front of your nose and you will lose them. So here you can see flax flowers. They are these purple flowers with the white sparkles around it, of course, and you have to find 10 of those. As I said, they are scattered all around the map. There are a couple here in this area. Try to find out where they are so you can collect these quicker. But you can also do the Sahha Match if you please. For me, the Sahha Match is... yeah. I did it too much, I guess. I don't really like it that much anymore. A nice place to collect these flax flowers, by the way, is back here where the... where you can get the fire blossom flowers, I guess it was called, because people don't typically go here, and you can also get them here. Let me collect the 10 and then I'll be back with you guys. Okay, after you've collected all 10 of the flex flowers, you go back to this guy here, Raal Voulot, and you give this these flax flowers, and you will get this either some materials. So here it says, if you do the flax flowers, you get materials for the profession, and I will go into that in a second. You get materials to craft your own Sahha Ball. If you do a Sahha Match, you will actually get a Zen voucher to get a Sahha Ball. So it's a little bit quicker if you do a match, but a match on the other hand takes longer. So you see I get 4 linseed and 8 flex fiber, and that's what I need. Let's go here, let's finish this one for example, and if you go into summer provisioning you can see everything that you craft. There are some I actually still have resources for this. You can get some fashion in here, but I will cover that later actually. So here you can see the Sahha Ball, but I need these sailcloths first. So you craft these. They take 30 seconds to craft. So we're going to wait for a second. Okay, that's number one. You have to do this 3 times to get 3 of these sailcloths, and then you can craft the ball. Okay, that's number 3. So now we can craft our Sahha Ball. This one takes 1 minute. Okay, so here we have our Sahha Ticket Ball. It ends up here. but you can put it on your belt. And here you can read that this year I have actually done 0 volleys at the moment, so 0 kicks as I mentioned them earlier. And you can see that after 150 of the volleys you can get silver tickets, and after 300 volleys you can get mithril tickets. So that was a nice slide into the next topic, the Sahha Balls. You, as you see here, have to put them on the belt slot, and what you should do to use these is find a party of 5 people and use this ball when you're in a party and close together. Once you spawn this ball, you have to keep kicking this ball up in the air. If it falls to the ground, the game ends and you cannot make more volleys. There also the game also ends when you have done a certain amount of volleys. I think it was like 20 per ball, something in that order of magnitude, maybe 15 or 20, something like that. If you stand under a bridge, and this is one of the bridges, and you use the ball and you start kicking it, it'll actually stick to the bridge and you can keep kicking it. If you don't stand under a bridge and you kick it, you will kick it forward, so it will be a lot more difficult. So if you want to use this ball, make sure to stand under a bridge, preferably a little bit far ahead. You can use this bridge, but you can also use the bridge up here. You will see many, many parties at these bridges using the balls. And when you use your ball, just start kicking the ball as quick as you can. You click it by pressing, or you kick it, not you click it. You kick it by clicking on your left mouse button for PC, that is. So when you kick the ball, rewards will fall out of the ball and they will drop around you. It is a clan member, guild member. So yeah, you should stand on a bridge and kick it the maximum amount of times. It doesn't matter if other people are kicking it as well, you don't need to do that, but make sure you keep kicking so it doesn't drop on the floor. Oh, my pick is a little bit weird here. Typically these parties these parties work with an ABC order, in the order of names. If someone does not agree with this, beware, because people sometimes will not use their balls, which is of course a bit annoying. So yeah, let's do a demonstration. I have one ball, let's use it. Typically I want to keep one ball to have the counter inside, because if you use your last ball you don't have a counter anymore, but for the sake of this video I will use this ball. Let me find a party and then I'll be back. Alright, so we are here together now. Oh, we're waiting for the guy with an A. He's going first. Oh, someone doesn't know how to use it. Ah, here we go. Someone else is helping. So you can kick with multiple people, and this fireworks means that it's this ball is done. You don't have to press any button to pick stuff up. You can just walk over it and you will You see to the right, you will get a lot of the Fire Blossom petals. So let's do one more, and then I'll finish this party alone. You can also stand under here to pick up the rewards, so you don't have to run around as much. But yeah, there I got a first copper ticket, and a second one, which is always nice. So, that was the demonstration for the Sahha Ball. Now I will show you a little bit about the Sahha Match. You can actually queue for it in here, as I showed before, and it will queue pretty quick, typically, because people are doing this a lot. Mostly because this is the second way to get your Sahha Ball, and you don't have to use professions. So let's get into it. It's 10 people this match. You actually also have to kick a Sahha Ball, so that's the similarity. There's no bridge here, and you actually have to try to kick the ball into this super big goal. As you can see here, people are using a ball, but this is not an actual match. This is just so here we are in the game. Actually, everyone will start on one of these spots, and the ball will drop from the top. And basically, you have to use your skills to try to kick the balls. If the ball goes out, it only means that the ball starts from the center again. So there's no free kick or something like that. And as you can see, I have a couple of skills bought, but not everything. It's a little bit buggy and slow and laggy, but it takes 10 minutes. I'm not going to bore you guys with 10 minutes of... Okay, so that was the game. We actually lost. And at the end, you can open this chest and you will get some basic stuff. I don't think with a win you will get a lot better stuff. But yeah, it's a neat little mini game in here. Talking about mini games, there are three other ones in here. Okay, I cannot mount here. Let's see, the water battle. You also have Hungry Trolls, which is in the same area. And you have the Summer Feast, which is in this area. So let's get on our mount, our piggy. And let's go to the water battle first. So in a water battle, it's basically the idea to pick up stuff here. You can pick up water skins, water buckets, and also decanters, they're called. And each of these gives you... I got hit. Gives you a skill that you can put on your belt slot. So let me put them here. You get 2 at a time from the buckets, 5 at a time from water skins, and 1 at a time from the decanter. And then you just use your belt powers. They have a cooldown. And you try to get some points. 0 points, nice. Still 0, okay. So this is basically messing around like this. I think it takes 15 minutes max. And you basically get some more of the very basic rewards. I'm going to leave these guys at it. Let me remove this stuff. Discard. So as you can see here, you have to pick it up all the time. Every time you want to use. Okay, I had the boulder. Every time you want to use a skill, you use up a charge. If you have the never-ending items from the petal store, you don't have to pick up new ones. So I mean, these here: bottomless water skin, everlasting water bucket, and decanter of endless water. They do cost a few petals, but once again, you will get plenty of those. That's the first mini game. Once this one finishes, I will talk you through the next one. And here you can see you get again some really basic rewards. Let's see what the next one is. So the Summer Feast mini game is active now. You can see this ring around this farm area, and what you have to do is try to chase animals into the farm. Animals will always run away from you, so you have to stand behind them to chase them in. A chicken gives 2 points, as you can see. Let's chase in another chicken. That's another 2 points. You can also grab corn here, which I think will give take all. So I got some corn. I didn't really pick that one. If you grab some corn, you have to bring it over here, but you need 10 ears of corn. Let's get 10. Oh, that's 8. So I should have enough now. And if I give that, I got 5 points. The last thing you can herd into the farm is actually the pigs, and they give, I think, if I remember correctly, the most points. Because they are behind the farm, so you have to move a little bit from the back. It's a little bit more difficult, but nothing that special. And pigs give 7 points. So this is what you basically do for, how long is it? 15 minutes, and then this event is done. I'm not going to do this for 15 minutes, so I will be back with you guys when this event is over. Alright, did a little bit better this event. Got second place, and I got once again. It's not like you're getting super great stuff, it's just some profession stuff and some food. So I hope the next event is the last one, the Hungry Trolls it's called, and it's basically a Kill the Trolls event. I will show you a little bit of it. I will not finish it completely because my recording is getting too long. I will be back when that event is started, or at least when I find it. Alright, so here's the last of the three mini events. Basically, you go to this area, as I said, and trolls will come walking down the mountain and you kill them. For every troll you kill, you get points, and that's about it. in the end, there will be a final boss that you have to kill with everyone on the map, and then you're done. So basically just a DPS event, nothing really special. I think there are not that many people here. Normally it's very, very buzzy when you're doing this. This is also nice, as you can see, to get some of the utility enchantment procs. So yeah, that's about it for the mini events. Let's kill these, and then we're going home. Let's get out of here. I don't want to get bothered by trolls, hungry ones. So the last item on the agenda, and we've already mentioned it a couple of times, and we looked at it a couple of times, is the professions. So there is for this event a separate profession available. It goes up to rank level 3. You do need to craft some stuff for it, like these Grand Summer Fests, I think. Yeah, this is for level 2 to 3. You need to prepare 3 of these. And from 1 to 2 is actually not here anymore. Okay, that's interesting. But I think you also need some of these. You will see it in the list when you get to it. You always have only one of these summer provisioning people, so you can only do one task at a time. You can see you can craft food. Here's the stuff for making the Sahha Ball, some more food, some more consumables. Yeah, temporary decoration for your guild, some more. This is another feast that gives some items, and this is some of the fashion stuff which you can also craft. You do need to do the dailies to get these reagents for or resources for that gear. But yeah, that's something extra in here. That's it for the event. It has been a quite long recording, but I will try to cut it down as much as I can. If you have any remarks on this video or any suggestions on what to investigate next, feel free to leave a comment below, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next video.